There he is. One of the most common garden pests out there. But they aren't insects. They are a land-dwelling mollusk. In other words, they're closely related to a clam, or not to a beetle or a caterpillar. Slugs in the garden are serious business. They leave slime trails and damaged leaves and missing seedlings. Figuring out a way to get rid of the slug in the garden is full of old wives' tales and many, many homemade remedies. So why is slug control challenging? Probably the biggest reason is the factor. They truly are slimy. And some slugs are there and we don't even notice them because they work on decomposing material in the garden. But the slug species we have prefers to live on living plant material. They don't carry a shell on their back. Instead, they have a small thing called, it's like a saddle, and they call it the mantle. Slugs tend to feed at night or on rainy days. They tend to hide under rocks or in other dark, moist conditions. So what would the plant detective do? What would the garden detective do to help in the garden to get rid of slugs? Since slugs feed primarily at night, gardeners tend to notice the damaged plants, but they can't find the culprit when they search the garden during the day. So maybe the detective should go out with their magnifying glass and look around and ask a few questions and talk and ask about the plant that it's eating. So how do we figure this out? And then when we do know that it's a slug, let's talk about what we can do to control it. What does slug damage really look like? Slugs go after the young seedlings like lettuces that are just coming up and many tender-leaved plants. There are some surefire signs that a garden slug control program is called for. If you come out to the garden in the morning and nothing remains of your seedlings but mid-leaf stuff and a few stumps, the slugs are likely your culprit. Perfect round holes in tomatoes, strawberries, and other soft fruits can also indicate a need to learn how to get rid of slugs in the garden. Ragged holes in leaf edges and centers is another sign of slugs. Slime trails, which are literally shiny and scoot around in odd ways, and they do shine. You can literally hold them up in the sunlight and they will shine. And they will show where they're leaving from the plants or where they're going up on a wall or a rock, or they hide in the mulch. So you want to look to see if that's what you've got as well. So the detective is looking at two or three things while they're going after this. Now that we understand a little bit more about these garden pests, it's time to look at some ways to keep slugs out of the gardens. And I try to use mainly natural methods. I don't want to put anything in my garden, especially when I'm growing lettuces and food crops. So I look at the cultural practice, what I'm going to do in the garden to stop slugs from coming in. I look at how I water. I never water late in the day because the slugs love that. They think that they can just slide through them. Remember, they're kind of icky and slimy, so they can slide through the water. And then I use, sometimes around the edges of the beds, I will plant some fuzzy-leaved plants, or I will plant some very fragrant herbs. And one that comes to my mind immediately is lavender, or I will put out sage, and that will usually stop them. They don't like that. Over the years, I've been using eggshells to create a speed bump to get rid of my slugs, and it has been almost completely successful. And how I do it is I save them all winter long. I gradually build a collection in my jars. And what I will do is I will keep them and let them dry a bit. But before I even put them in the jar, I wash them and let them dry. And then I dry them a bit more. And I gradually, over the winter, I can fill 2 to 3 jars. I recently switched from white eggs to brown eggs. So I've got several going on. And I keep crushing them deeper and deeper into the jar. Now, the last stage is that I take my blender. And my blender takes them and crushes them into a really fine, fine layer. And all those sharp edges all those sharp edges will cut up the skin of the slug. You see, there's more ick for you having the slug get in there, and he will try to crawl back over the speed bump, and he will struggle. He will struggle to the point where he's finding them, you know, that it cuts him up. So he's not going to be very happy when I'm done. But that is, in my mind, one of my favorite slug methods. And believe me, I've also been known to go out in the garden, and I have a thing that I sling them out in the middle of the lawn, and the birds love them. So I don't like to use any natural, non-natural cures, because I still want the birds to have a food source. So eggs in the garden, there's something you didn't think of.